In economics, we use experimental methods to get at the causal effect. Without experimental methods, we will not be able to give policy advice of how one variable affects another.
Lab experiments are the wind tunnel of economic research. They allow us to control the environment in which economic decisions are made, and that in turn makes it possible for us to interpret differences in economic behavior.
Natural experiments is that it's a policy change, for instance, changing education policy, maternity leave policies, and from the combination of data and these policy changes, we can identify causal effects and not only correlations.
Well, it's obvious that people care about fairness, but it's less obvious what people actually do find fair and what they do not find fair.
Because it underlies every aspect of human life, from our relationships with our family, to our relationships with our employers, to every pressing societal issue that we're facing and arguing about. Fairness seems to be what makes people angry, and when things are fair, it makes them happier.
It's important to study inequality to understand how we can help every child reach his or her potential.
When you have inequality, it's like leaving money on the table. And that's because human capital is one of the most important engines for growth in the economy. And so when you have a group of children, most often those born to those families in society with the fewest resources who are not reaching their full potential in terms of their human capital development, then the economy suffers and society suffers.
Many disciplines talk about rationality. But I think that the simplest, most transparent definition of rationality comes from economics. And it's very important before doing any empirical analysis to basically see whether individual choice behavior is rational in the sense of maximizing an underlying utility function or an underlying objective.